Okay, good morning to everyone. So today we are going to discuss unit 3, P block element 2. So already we have completed P block 1. In P block 1, we discussed the group number 13, group number 14. So P block element 2. So we are going to discuss group number 15, 16, 17 and 18. In group number 15, nitrogen group, or you can say nitrogen group. Okay. So in that, occurrence, physical properties, and then nitrogen, phosphorus. So nitrogen compounds, ammonia, nitric acid, and oxides and oxyacids of nitrogen, structure only. And in phosphorus, we are going to discuss allotropic form of phosphorus. Then properties of phosphorus. Then compounds of phosphorus, we are going to discuss phosphine, phosphorus trichloride, phosphorus pentachloride. And then oxides and oxyacids, we are going to discuss only structure. Then group number 16, salcogen. So group number 15, nitrogen. Group number 16, salcogen. Okay. Occurrence, physical properties, oxygen and sulfur. Oxygen and sulfur. Okay. And then in sulfur, we are going to discuss allotropy of sulfur and then compound of sulfur, sulfur dioxide, sulfuric acid. Then oxyacids of sulfur, structure only. And 17th group, halogen group. 17th group also called as halogen group. In that, only one element. Okay. In 15th group, two elements, nitrogen, phosphorus. In the 16th group, two elements, oxygen, sulfur. But in 17th group, we are going to discuss only one element, that is chlorine. Okay. And then compound of chlorine, we are going to discuss hydrochloric acid. And some physical and chemical properties, strength of hydrogen halides. Then interhalogen compounds, then oxides and oxyacids of halogen. Then group number 18, inert gases, or you can say noble gases. Okay, the lot of topics covered in this area, but we are going to cover only occurrence, properties and the uses. Okay, the first one is nitrogen. So nitrogen, the main source of nitrogen is air. So the air contains 78%. The atmospheric air contains 78% of nitrogen. So this nitrogen is non-combustible substance which do not support for combustion reaction. Okay. So the rate of combustion is moderate. Okay. The main reason is the air contains 78% nitrogen. And then the concentration of oxygen is very, very important for breathing purpose. Okay. So in air, around 20% of air content, that is 20% of oxygen present in the air. Okay. But if you increase the concentration of oxygen, or if you reduce the percentage of oxygen in air, it will affect the rate of breathing. So the rate of breathing mainly depends on the percentage of oxygen present in the air. Okay. So this percentage of nitrogen is very, very important for breathing. Okay, right. The next one is the nitrogen also present in earth crust, in the form of nitrate. Okay, you can see the picture of liquid nitrogen. Okay, the liquid nitrogen equilibrium with its gaseous state. Okay, but in earth crust, nitrogen, in the form of nitrate. Okay, sodium nitrate, silicon saltpeter, and potassium nitrate, indium saltpeter. So the other name of potassium nitrate, indium saltpeter. The other name of sodium nitrate is silicon saltpeter. So important one word question. Okay. And then the 11th most abundant element is phosphorus. The first most abundant element in the earth crust is oxygen. But in atmosphere, the highest percentage for nitrogen. But in earth crust, the highest percentage for oxygen. Okay. nearly 45.5% oxygen present in the earth crust. That is the most abundant element in the earth crust. And the second one is silicate. The third one is aluminium. The seventh one is carbon. The 11th one is phosphorus in the form of phosphate. Okay, fluoroapatite, chloroapatite, hydroxyapatite. Okay, right. The next one is, okay, in addition to phosphorus, other elements are also present in the earth crust. Okay, arsenic, antimony, bismuth in the form of sulfide. Okay, this is only tracer amount only present in the earth crust. Okay, the next one is nitrogen. Okay, so we are having biodata. So like that, every element having biodata. Okay, the important data for every element is atomic number, symbol, configuration, atomic weight, acid-base nature, structural arrangement, physical state. So these are the basic biodata for every element. Okay, so what is the biodata for nitrogen element? Okay, nitrogen atomic number 7, configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. So instead of writing 1s2, you can write helium, noble gas symbol you can write. So helium 2s2, 2p3. So this one is comes under 15th group elements. So the number of valence electron 5. Okay. So the group oxidation state 5. So valence electron is equal to group oxidation state. That is the maximum oxidation state. So the 15th group nitrogen group elements, the maximum oxidation state is plus 5. Okay. Because they are having 5 electron in the outermost cell. So down a group, the number of energy level increases, but the number of electrons same. Okay, right. The next one is atomic weight 14. Okay, then acid-base nature. Okay, nitrogen forms strongly acidic. You can say that nitric acid. Nitric acid is a strong acid. Okay, right. The next one is the crystal arrangement. So the gases or nitrogen can be converted into nitrogen below critical temperature. And then liquid nitrogen can be converted into solid nitrogen. The solid nitrogen having the hexagonal arrangement. Hexagonal arrangement. Okay, right. So nitrogen is a non-metal. Nitrogen is a non-metal. Okay, and the only element in the gaseous state in nitrogen group is nitrogen. And other elements are in the solid state. So here you can see that the red phosphorus. So phosphorus exhibit in different allotropic form, white phosphorus, lead phosphorus, like that. Okay, this is the red phosphorus. Atomic number 15. Okay, configuration neon 3s2 3p3. So nitrogen having only 2 energy level, but the phosphorus having 3 energy level. Okay, but the number of valence electrons same. Okay, so as in the nitrogen element. Atomic weight 30.9. So you can round up to 31. Then acid base, this is a weakly acidic nature. Okay, so nitrogen can form strong acidic compound, but a phosphorus can form the weak acidic compound. So nitric acid is a strong acid, but a phosphoric acid is a weak acid. Okay, right. And then crystal structure, cubic arrangement. So in solid state, we discussed the, okay, 7 type of unit cells. Okay, that one of the type is cubic arrangement. And then arsenic. So arsenic is a non-metal, okay, that is metalloids. So arsenic example for metalloid. But the non-metallic nature is predominant, okay, in arsenic. Okay, it looks like metal, but a non-metallic nature is predominant. Okay, atomic number 33, configuration argon 3d10, 4s2, 4p3. So here d orbital is empty. Okay, in nitrogen, there is no d orbital, only 2 energy level, there is no d orbital. But phosphorus having d orbital, but a d orbital is empty. But in arsenic, d orbital is filled one, 3d10. So after d block elements, okay, the arsenic comes, so it's having 3d10 electron. So this one differ the, okay, character of arsenic from other elements because presence of 3d10 electron. Okay, and then atomic weight for 74.9. And acid-base nature, this also form weakly acidic nature. And the crystal structure, rhombohedral. So previous one, cubic. But here, rhombohedral. Then antimony, so this also comes under metalloid. So metalloids means which is having metal and non-metal character. But here the antimony, which one is predominant? The metallic nature is predominant. So here it is referred as metal, but here it is referred as non-metal. The reason is both are metalloids, but in arsenic the non-metallic character is predominant, but in antimony the metallic nature is predominant. Because down a group the metallic nature increases. The reason is decreasing ionization energy. So antimony predominantly having metallic nature rather than non-metal. Atomic number 51. Okay, electronic configuration: krypton 4d10 5s2 5p3. Okay, so all elements having the same number of electrons, 5. So which one is differing? The number of energy level differing, but the number of electron in the outermost shell are same. Okay, so atomic weight 121.7. Acid base nature, this also form weakly acidic nature. Crystal structure, this also form rhombohedral. The last one is bismuth. So bismuth is a metal, pure metal. Okay, so nitrogen, phosphorus, non-metal. Nitrogen, phosphorus, non-metal. And then arsenic, antimony, metalloids. Arsenic, antimony, metalloids. And bismuth is a metal. So atomic number 83. And the configuration xenon 4f14, 5d10, 6s2, 6p3. So here the electron, okay, which is also present in 4f orbital. But here 4f orbital is empty. But here 4f orbital is completely filled. Okay. So the number of energy level increases. The electron accommodated in s orbital, p orbital, d orbital, and then f orbital. Okay. Then the crystal structure, this also rhombohedral arrangement. So these are the basic biodata of nitrogen group elements. Then here the comparative studies of nitrogen group elements. So physical state, nitrogen is only gas, other are solid one. Okay, nitrogen only can form nitrogen 14 isotope, nitrogen 15 isotope, but other can form only one isotope. So like that, the behavior of nitrogen is different from other element in the same group. So already we discussed in previous chapter the anomalous nature of first element of p-block elements. Okay, the reason is small size, high ionization energy, high electronegativity, like that we have seen. Okay, the reason. Okay, so here nitrogen is a gas, other elements are solid. So there are different physical properties, comparative studies given in a numerical way. The next one is the physical properties. After preparation only physical properties given, but we discuss first physical properties, then preparation. Okay, so nitrogen is a inert gas. Okay, so due to inert only, rate of combustion with the air is limited one. Okay, otherwise the rate of combustion will be increased. But air contains 78% nitrogen, which reduce the rate of combustion of many inflammable material. Okay, then the terrestrial nitrogen contains 14.5 and 0.4% of nitrogen 14 isotope and nitrogen 15 isotope. Okay, so which one is more? The nitrogen 14 isotope is more when compared with the nitrogen 15 isotope. But the nitrogen 15 isotope used for the isotopic labeling. So isotopic labeling means what? The many mechanism, can be studied with the help of the labeled elements. Okay, so here nitrogen 15, a labeled isotope used to study the mechanism of many reactions. And then the inertness of nitrogen mainly due to the high dissociation energy. The bond dissociation energy is very high. Why the bond dissociation energy is very high? Because nitrogen having the multiple bond. So nitrogen having triple bond. So the bond dissociation energy is very high. So which leads to the inertness to the nitrogen. The next one is the triple bond species. Nitrogen is a triple bond species. Okay, when compared with the other triple bond species, isoelectronic triple bond system, carbon carbon, carbon oxygen, carbon nitrogen, nitrogen carbon. So other triple bond system, if you compare the reactivity, the nitrogen triple bond nitrogen is less reactive in nature. Okay, and then this nitrogen dinitrogen which cannot donate electron, but other triple bond system can donate electron. So here carbon oxygen is a ligand in the formation of complex compound. The carbon monoxide easily donate pair of electron to the central membrane in the formation of complex compound. Nitrogen can also form complex with metal, but the formation is, the rate of formation is less when compared with the carbon monoxide. So both having triple bond, but the rate of formation of complex for nitrogen is less when compared with the carbon monoxide. So preparation. So you can prepare nitrogen from air. First we had to liquefy the air. Okay, so already we discussed in gaseous state. If you want to liquefy the substance below critical temperature and the immersion temperature, then only gas can be liquefied. So there are two type of gas we discussed. One is a permanent gas, another one is temporary gas. So temporary gas we can easily liquefy, but a permanent gas under rigorous condition only we can liquefy. So nitrogen, permanent gas. So under rigorous condition only the nitrogen can be liquefied. But air is a mixture of gases, so we can easily liquefy air. So this liquefied air, subjected to fractional distillation, we can easily separate nitrogen from air. The next second method is preparation of pure nitrogen from aside compound. So aside is a organic functional group. So this aside compound on decomposition at the temperature of 575 Kelvin, so nitrogen gas is obtained. So N means atom of nitrogen, N2 molecular nitrogen, N3 is a functional group, is called as aside group. Carboxylic acid, hydroxy group, ketone group, ether group, like that aside group. So sodium aside subjected to thermal decomposition at the temperature of 575 Kelvin, nitrogen, pure nitrogen molecule is obtained. So you can also prepare from ammonia. So ammonia, which undergoes oxidation with bromine. So bromine is an oxidizing agent, so which oxidizes ammonia into ammonium bromide and nitrogen. So here, what is the oxidation number of nitrogen? Here the oxidation number is -3. Here the oxidation number is -3. In ammonium, what is the oxidation number? Ammonium bromide, what is the oxidation number of nitrogen? +5. Okay. And what is the oxidation number of nitrogen molecule? 0. Okay. So here -3 to +5. Okay. -3 to 0. So loss of electron, gain of electron. So both involving. So this is the example for disproportionation reaction. The next one is chemical properties of nitrogen. So nitrogen can react with the nitrogen molecules. Reacts with the alkali metals and the alkaline earth metals. So lithium can react with the nitrogen, which is lithium nitride. So this one is somewhat covalent nature. Already we discussed in 11th standard. Next one is alkaline earth metals. So calcium reacts with the nitrogen at a red hot, which gives calcium nitride. And boron reacts with the nitrogen, gives boron nitride. So the second group elements reacts with the nitrogen form ionic nitrides. Ionic nitrides at the elevated temperature. That means at a high temperature only the reaction carry out. So boron is a non-metal. Nitrogen also non-metal. So reacts together under red hot, under vigorous condition only, the boron nitride is formed. So this boron nitride, structure of boron nitride is similar to graphite structure. So this one is very important entrance question. The structure of boron nitride, hexagonal, like a graphite. Graphite also having hexagonal structure. So reaction with the alkali metals and alkaline earth metals. The next one is Haber process. Haber process, synthesis of ammonia. So synthesis of ammonia is a very very important one, because we can prepare fertilizer urea from ammonia only. Okay, so ammonia synthesized from nitrogen. So nitrogen reacts with the hydrogen in 3:1 ratio. Okay, under rigorous condition, that is high pressure and the optimum temperature. Okay, in the presence of ion catalyst. Okay, so this is a very very important reaction in discussing equilibrium. Okay, so this is equilibrium reaction. Synthesis of ammonia is equilibrium reaction. For industrial preparation is very difficult for equilibrium reaction, because we have to maintain lot of condition, reaction condition, then only we can get pure product. Okay, so Haber process, so synthesis of ammonia from nitrogen. So nitrogen and hydrogen, okay, you have to take in 3:1 ratio under high pressure and optimum temperature. In the presence of ion catalyst, we will get ammonia. So this ammonia is used for the preparation of manufacture of your fertilizer. That fertilizer used in agriculture industry. The next one is oxygen, nitrogen, both are present in air. Oxygen, nitrogen, both are present in air. But oxygen and nitrogen, which do not react each other under normal condition. Okay, under high temperature only, around 3473 Kelvin, that is 3473 Kelvin only, the reaction takes place. Okay, only the small amount of product is obtained, that is 4.4% only. So nitrogen reacts with oxygen, which gives nitrous oxide. But if you change the ratio of reactant, you will get the lot of oxide compound. Okay, so nitric oxide, what is the formula? NO. Nitrous oxide, what is the formula? N2O. Nitrogen dioxide, what is the formula? NO2. Okay, then dinitrogen trioxide, what is the formula? N2O3. Okay, then dinitrogen tetraoxide, what is the formula? N2O4. Okay, so dinitrogen pentoxide, what is the formula? N2O5. Okay, so nitrogen and oxygen, okay, which combine in different ratio, okay, so which gives different product. So nitrogen and oxygen, which do not react under normal condition, under rigorous condition only the reaction takes place. Okay, so during lightning time, this nitrogen combined with oxygen form oxides of nitrogen. So this one is very important for nitrogen cycle. This is very very important for nitrogen cycle. Okay, right. The last one is uses of nitrogen. Okay, so nitrogen is used for the manufacture of many compounds, useful compounds. So ammonia, nitric acid, calcium cyanamide, okay, and a cyanide compound. Many compounds can be prepared from nitrogen. And then the liquid nitrogen is used for producing low temperature required in cryogenic, that is cryosurgery. So cryosurgery means what? Okay, the surgery which take place under low temperature. Actually, it must be cryogenic one. Engine is that, technology is that. Okay, that technology work out at low temperature only. Okay, so that low temperature can be attained with the help of liquid nitrogen. And then nitrogen also used in biological preservation. So today we have completed nitrogen. So this one is big chapter. Chapter 3 is very very big. We have to discuss 15th chapter, element, compound, then 16th one, 17, 18. So it's a very big chapter. So we have completed up to 3.13. So occurrence, physical properties, nitrogen.
Thank you students. I hope you understand the concept. Keep learning. Stay reactive.